students from the diploma in experience and product design, they get to design engagements. At the same time, what they do is to make these engagements real. They make them into products, etc., or services, or anything that could enrich people's life through these engagements. Now, what are engagements? Engagements are interaction of people with people, perhaps with objects, with spaces. So it's a broad spectrum of things that the DXPD studies, or at least the students get involved in. Our students look into the packaging of things, as well as spaces, to products, and they conceive services as well. Essentially, while students are doing this, there's a lot of experimentations that entails in this, in the process of design when students are thinking about such engagements. To experiment and to understand so that through this exploration, they can get interesting outcomes that would be more perhaps engage people a bit better. Yeah.
When we speak of experimentation in games, it could be coming from something as straightforward as an apple. So you may have seen many games with collecting apples as the game mechanic. Apple drops down from the tree and you move the basket to collect it. So that is perhaps the origin of many game ideas. But how we experiment with this, how we come up with new ideas from this, that is part of the whole process where we what we do in games design and development. You have an idea, but you need to look into it, you need to come up with new forms of it. It's not so straightforward, and it definitely won't be the first idea that you think of. But this is a journey, and the end game, the end idea, the end game product says it all. It says how good you are with games, it says how good you are with ideas.
At the Diploma of Interior Design, we explore and design what are the spaces that forms between the man and his enclosure. In that enclosure, we begin to redefine what is this enclosure that surrounds the space of man. Must the wall that is in the enclosure be a straight wall? Must it be made of brick? How must this wall be different? And that's where we begin to experiment with ways of rethinking what the enclosure is. If the wall is able to capture the motion of man, if the floor is able to capture the heartbeat of a man, how different will the floor be? How different will the wall be? And how different can that ceiling be, which forms the enclosure, which surrounds the spaces that enclose the man?
So what is experimentation for visual communications? And it means actually a very simple thing. We try to do different things. We try to communicate in different ways. So for example, I could change my message or change the way that I say the message, or I could actually change the way I relate to the audience. I could change who is speaking, right? I could play around the form and change, let's say, the apple into a pear, right? So the thing is that the message will come out with very interesting, unexpected twists, which makes it fun and surprising, rather than just, I could just write the word apple and pass it to you, right? So for visual comms, experimentation is really a very important part of the process. It makes us try new things, think different things, think of new ways to do things, and to make the communication experience, you know, so much better than before.
Experimentation is an ethos that the Singapore Polytechnic Design School adopted. And one of the main reasons we wanted to do this is because we want our students to find new meanings in the world they live and experience. And to do that, I think they need to question, which is to experiment and test out ideas in all that they work with, work in, think about. May it be with spaces, with games, with print media or objects. And I think if just only by experimenting, students, student designers would be able to discover potentials in the world they live in, the materials they work with, and the craft they want to develop as designers for the future.